Hello friends, my name is Parshuram Patel and today we will discuss another topic and that is trigonometric Fourier series. So welcome to all of you. Trigonometric Fourier series. Okay, so here any periodic waveform that is one for which ft is equal to f of t plus minus nt can be expressed by a Fourier series provided that these are some conditions and also known as Dirichlet conditions. What does it mean by ft equal to f of t plus minus nt? Because this is a periodic waveform, so waveform ft is periodic with the fundamental period capital T. Okay, ft equal to f of t plus t, t plus 2t, t plus 3t, t plus minus nt, that is integer multiple of fundamental period T. So it is a periodic waveform and any periodic waveform can be represented in terms of trigonometric Fourier series. Okay. So there are some Dirichlet conditions for this purpose. First one is if it is discontinuous, there are only a finite number of discontinuous in the period T. Okay. If there are discontinuous, that discontinuous must be a finite number in the duration of fundamental period capital T. It has a finite average value over the period capital T, average value of must be finite, and it has a finite number of positive and negative maxima. Okay, minima and maxima must be finite number in the duration of fundamental period T. So when these Dirichlet conditions are satisfied, the Fourier series exists and can be expanded into the infinite trigonometric series. So okay, if any periodic waveform following these three Dirichlet conditions, then it can be expanded in terms of infinite trigonometric series and can be written as ft equal to some dc term half times a naught plus a1 cos omega 1t plus a2 cos twice omega t, a3 cos 3 omega t in terms of cos and in terms of sine, similarly b1 sin omega naught omega t plus b2 sin twice omega t plus b3 sin 3 omega t. So here we can combine these terms. First one is dc term a0 by 2 plus remaining all the terms are in terms of cosine and sine. So we will write this expression of cosine as cos n omega naught t and coefficient is an, where n vary from 1 to infinity. Similarly, sines bn sin n omega t, where n vary from 1 to infinity. So we can combine within the bracket that sum of an cos n omega t plus bn sin n omega t, where n is from 1 to infinity. Here coefficients, that is a0, a1, a2, b1, b2, b3, is just like a spectrum of the given sequence. Spectrum means frequency components. Okay. So where a0, a1, a2, b1, b2, b3 are coefficients of harmonics of ft. Just like you have studied in Laplace transform, Jacques transform, Fourier transform, that ft is a signal and fz, okay, fz, f omega, these are the frequency components, spectrum. Similarly, in Fourier series, a0, a1, a2, b1, b2, b3, these are coefficients of harmonics and these coefficients constitute a frequency domain description of the signal, just like spectrum, just like frequency domain. Okay, so a0, a1, a2, b1, b2, b3, these coefficients are harmonics of ft and these are coefficients. These coefficients constitute a frequency domain description of the signal. Okay, so any infinite trigonometric series can be written like this. Now we have to find the coefficients values. Okay, that is frequency domain analysis. So here a naught can be written as integration of the ft, integration of the periodic waveform over one time period, that is 0 to t multiplied by 2 by t. So here you will get the a0 by 2 is equal to 1 by 2 into 2 by t integration this. So here it will come integration of ft over the time period t divided by t. Okay. So what we have done? We have taken the summation of this waveform over one time period and divided by the same time period t. So it is the average value. So we can say this term is the DC value. Okay. So here f naught is equal to, so here sorry, ft equal to a naught by 2 plus this expression, and here a naught can be written as 2 by t integration of 0 to t ft dt. So what will be value of a naught by 2? A naught by 2 will be integration of ft over the time period t divided by t, that is average value, that is dc component. Okay, now we will proceed towards an. What is the an? It is the integration of ft cos n omega naught t. These are the harmonics of a fundamental term, that is integration of ft cos n omega t dt and multiplied by constant 2 by t. Okay, so here frequency component an, that is coefficient an, is equal to 2 by t integration of 0 to t ft cos n omega t dt, where omega equal to 2 pi by t and t is the fundamental period of the signal ft. Similarly, we can find bn. Here bn is equal to 2 by t integration over the one time period, fundamental time period t, ft sine n omega naught t dt. Here you have to observe that this integration for one time duration, and that time duration is fundamental period 0 to t. So it can be minus t by 2 to t by t, it can be 0 to t, it can be t to t plus t, any, but duration must be one time period capital T. So vn here 2 by t integration of 0 to t ft sine n omega t dt. So an, bn and a naught are known as Fourier series coefficients. So a naught, an and bn are known as Fourier series coefficients for the periodic waveform ft, and that can be written as a naught by 2 plus sum of n equal to 1 to infinity an cos n omega t plus bn sin n omega t. Value of a naught, integration ft dt multiplied by 2 by t, integration ft cos n omega t dt multiplied by 2 by t, this is an, and bn, integration of ft sin n omega t multiplied by 2 by t. Now Fourier series rectified sine wave. Here we have considered some example. So you can see this example here. A very popular, very good example, Fourier series of rectified sine wave. So here you can see this is the Fourier series of a rectified sine wave. Ft time, you know this is the sine wave and this is rectified sine wave. Okay. So you can see here value of this signal ft lie between 0 and t, that's why we are saying rectified. Okay, so rectified sine wave ft. Now from the diagram, from this figure, we can write ft equal to sine t, magnitude of sine t times a, because magnitude is oscillating between 0 and a, so it can be written here a times magnitude of sine t. Okay, here ft can be written as a times magnitude of sine t. Why we have taken here mod? This value is a, so we have taken here a. But why we have considered mod sine t inside the mod? Because here we have got all values upper side. Okay, this waveform is not going downside, it is not going towards the negative y axis. Okay, so all these values are upper side, means positive values. So here we have used the modulus. So ft can be written as a times mod of sine t, and ft is periodic. Each term is periodic with period pi. Here you can say this is the signal present for 0 to pi, and we have copy pasted everywhere. So these are the copies of the fundamental term 0 to pi, pi to 2 pi, 2 pi to 3 pi. So periodic with period t equal to pi. Okay, use the formula of Fourier series coefficient as we have read. To find the a naught, we have to use this formula, 2 by t integration of 0 to t ft dt, and here ft is a mod of sine t. So we have used here a mod of sine t. You know sine t is always positive in 0 to pi. Okay, value of sine t for time t equal to 0 to pi, that is positive, that is sine is positive in first and second quadrant. So you have read the earlier, you must be aware of modulus function, that is mod of x equal to x if x is greater than or equal to 0, and mod of minus x equal to minus x if x is less than 0. So here sine t is positive in 0 to pi, so magnitude of sine t can be directly written as sine t. Okay, and after solving this integration we will get 4a upon pi. Similarly, you have to find an. So an can be find out here, can be found out here, 2 by t integration of 0 to t ft cos n omega t dt. Here ft is magnitude of sine t, again integration is 0 to pi. One can say why we are using the limit 0 to pi, because fundamental period of this sine wave is 0 to pi. Okay, so we have to integrate these expressions up to one time period, and that time period is pi. You can take 0 to pi, minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, pi to 2 pi, but for simplification we have considered 0 to pi. Okay, and in 0 to pi sine t, value of sine t will be positive, so it can be written directly sine t cos 2 pi and t upon capital T dt. Here t is the fundamental period, and you can write the t equal to pi. You have observed from the diagram that is fundamental period is pi, so simply you can write here t equal to pi. So what will be omega? As you know, omega equal to 2 pi by t, that is fundamental frequency omega is equal to 2 pi by t, 2 pi by t. Okay, you can directly write omega equal to 2 pi by 2. So if you write omega equal to 2 pi by 2, you will get the value pi. Okay, so here t equal to pi, so omega will be 2. So you can expand this expression, and after solving this integration you will get this value. Okay, similarly you will get bn, and bn is equal to 2 by t integration f t sine n omega t. This is the formula of bn, and integration up to time period t. Here time period t is the 0 to pi, and we have read some concepts of integration while we have read the orthogonal functions. In orthogonal functions you have read that integration of product of sine mt and sine nt, sine m omega t or sine n omega t, where m and n can be at a time this signal cannot be zero. So integration of sine m omega t sine n omega t, where m and n are integers, and integration of this product over one time period will be zero. Zero times anything will be zero. So here bn will be zero. Okay, you have read this earlier. Okay, in orthogonal functions you can again recall this integration. So integration of sine m omega t sine n omega t is equal to zero if m and n both are integers in one time period 0 to t. This is the property of orthogonal functions. So 0 times anything bn will be 0. So we have got the an a naught 4a upon pi, we have got the an this one, and we have got the bn equal to 0 because this integration is 0. So Fourier series of the rectified sine wave can be written as such: ft equal to a naught by 2 plus sum of n equal to 1 to infinity an cos n omega t plus bn sine n omega t. After writing these values of a naught, an and bn, we will get this expression ft equal to 4a upon 2 pi 1 plus sum of, we have taken some common and combined here inside the summation, so we have got this relation. This is the Fourier series of the rectified sine wave. Hope you have understood it. Okay, now there is some important integration. Okay, in solving these questions you have used one integration of this one to find the a n. So we have solved this integration separately. Solve integration of sine t cos 2 n t dt 0 to pi. While you have found the trigonometric Fourier series expression, and after that you have find the expression of rectified sine wave, then you have used this integration. So how we can find the value of this integration? In this question you can understand it. Here I equal to integration of 0 to pi sine t cos 2 n t dt. Okay, so here we will use the integration property. Integration of first into second is first as it is, integration of second, okay, minus integration of second as it is, first integration and complete product integration. Okay, so here integration of first function into second function, that is product, that is property of product rule of integration have been applied here. So after that you have to integrate 0 to pi. So we have considered here cos 2nt first function and sin t second function. Okay, after taking the integration here, this one first as it is, integration of second minus integration of first function, okay, that is cos 2nt. Here you have find it, okay, and this is the integration of second function, okay, multiplied both, and that is dt, okay. Now after that you will have to apply the value of limit from 0 to pi, okay. So after that we have done here minus minus plus minus minus, and this constant 2n will come outside the integration, and here you can see this function is sin 2nt cos t, okay. Now again we know that this will repeat again, because derivation of sin will be cos, and again if you will derivate then again it will become sin. Similarly for integration, integration of sin and cos also repeat itself. So we have given the name of this expression is I, okay. So here I is equal to this expression, and limit is 0 to pi, that is this limit 0 to pi, okay. Now here you can see I is equal to minus cos t cos 2nt minus 2n, and this expression cos 2nt sin t, see the original question, cos 2nt sin t, this repeat itself here, so it is repeated as it is, and we have named this expression here I. So we will replace this expression again with I, okay. So we will get 4n square I, and we will shift this I term in left side and combining after that and taking the values from 0 to pi, we will get this answer, okay. As we know, sin pi is 0, sin 0 is 0, cos pi equal to minus 1, and cos of 2n pi, that is integer multiple of 2 pi is equal to 1. After solving we have got this expression 2 upon 1 minus 4n square. So integration of this term will be this, okay. Hope you have understood this property, okay. Now we will study the exponential Fourier series in next video, okay. So we will stop here. Thank you. Hope you have understood the problems, okay. Thank you.